Yesterday we people are discussing about this grouping and sorting technique, isn't it? So we'll have a recap of it once, then we can move on to the next topic. So we are seeing sorting. Sorting in the sense what you are seeing, arranging the data in one particular order. This is all about sorting. Here you can notice that we are having the table call. We made use of a table called my employee, isn't it? Where we created a table called my employee and we are using it there. So if at all you're displaying the data of my employee, you can notice that it will be displayed like this. The data will not be sorted. What happened? Just a minute. Okay, so this is the first time we are starting it, right? So we are supposed to make use of new student. So we'll then execute this, then we'll try to execute my employee. So if we execute my employee, we know that these are the information in my employee, isn't it? So you can notice that employee ID, employee name, salary, department ID, followed by the location. These are the information we store, but you can notice that the data is not in the proper order. Proper order in the sense, here what I mean is either ascending order, descending order is not there. If at all you want to arrange the data in one particular order, then you can mention select star from. You're supposed to make use of order by. Okay, order by in the sense arranging in one particular order followed by the column name, based on which column you want to arrange it. Here I mentioned employee ID. So if I execute this one, you can notice that based on the employee ID, if it is of alphabet, be arranged in A to Z order. So if it is of integer value, then you can notice that it is assumed based on salary I want to arrange it. So in those cases, you can mention salary here. What happened here is, it will arrange based on the integer value. If it is alphabet, it will arrange based on A to Z. If it is integer, it will arrange based on the values, lower value to the higher value. So default here, I didn't give anything. So by default, sorting is ascending order. If you want, you can give manually as ASC. It is not a mandatory to give it. If you are leaving this one also, even then it will short only in ascending order. So if you want the same data to be mentioned in descending order, you're supposed to add one more column followed by order by, that is DESC. So the same data will be arranged in the descending order, where the highest salary person will be at the topmost and the remaining person will be following him. This is all about your descending order. Okay, so if I give like this descending order by salary comma employee name, EMP name, ascending, just a minute, ascending, descending order followed by, okay, let me imagine, ascending order or descending. This is not accepted here. In Oracle, it accepts both things. This is not accepted. Based on two columns, we can sort in Oracle. Yeah, this is not allowed. Okay, it's okay. We'll leave out this. I'm not confusing it. So right now, let it be as such. So if you want ascending, make it of ASC. If you want descending, make it as DESC. So this is that. And I guess you people are clear with order by. And next is group by. Group by in the sense, based on one column, you're going to group it. Based on the department, I want to group it. For example, in this table, if you want to group the employee based on department, and I want to know the employee count in each and every department. If this is a scenario, then I can make use of select. I want to count the number of employees, right? So I can mention count of employee ID, okay, followed by the department. So what does it mean? I have two columns to be displayed. One is the count, another is the department ID. So each and every department followed by the count of them, each and every department is going to display. And here I'm going to group based on the department ID. So if the department ID is same, I'll group the particular department. and I'll have a count will be stored here. You can group based on the location also. It's up to you. Based on location, I can group it. So if at all you find that when the data is repeated, then I can group it based on the salary. The person who gets same salary can be grouped like this. Okay, based on certain column, I can able to group it. So make sure that based on which column you're grouping, only those column can be occurring here. Here I can't able to use select the names with the select and count followed by the name. The reason is in the department ID 500, I can notice that many people are there. I can't able to list out all the things. The reason is I'm going to give only one count here for your count column. So if you're giving try to do like this, it will throw you error. That's not possible. Make sure that whatever the department you're going to group by, the same column can be projected here or can be displayed. Apart from this, other column is not possible to do it. This is an important point group by. So I'm going to group this information based on the department ID. So if I group this information based on the department ID, so based on the department number, the data will be grouped. So you can notice that the department ID 200 has 4 employees, 300 has 2 employees, 400 has 2 employees, and 500 has 3 employees. This is how the data is grouped. So here, in the next example, what you're going to see is you're going to see with group by, followed by, order by. So let us take the other example where you're going to group based on the location where they are located. And when I'm fetching the location, when I mention the location, you can notice that location is of string type. So I want to arrange this data location in a descending order after finding the count of it. So based on which one I'm going to order by, based on the location I want to order by in descending order. So if I give this one, you can notice that Delhi 4 employee, Chennai 5 employee, Bangalore 1 employee, and AP 1 employee. Here I'm trying to order by based on my location. So if you want to base it based on my count value, I can do it. Based on count value, try to do it. So then based on your count value, it will produce in descending order. So you can order by based on any column, group by based on any column, but make sure that whatever the column you're grouped by, the same column can be given. Apart from that, one aggregate function map can be added along with it. Okay, no other column can be added along with it if it is not a relevant one. Is it clear with the order by and group by? Shall we move on to next one? Okay, good. And next topic, what you're going to see is you're going to see with the key constraint, the most important topic in database. So let me take a note back. So what is this key constraint all about? So far, we are seeing creation of table, all those things. But when it came up, we did not hear about the constraint. It is all about applying condition for a column. Constraint in the sense condition. So you're going to apply some condition and you're going to work with it. So speaking about the constraint, there are different types of constraints are available. We'll see one by one. So constraint, this is what I told you, is your condition, or we can use a specific rule, any rule. Those things comes under constraint. So we'll be having not null. Not null in the sense, if you feel that certain columns is mandatory, the user cannot leave the column without filling. In those cases, I should mention not null. Okay, so the reason here is, if we go back here, just a minute. Here, while I'm filling the data, I can give null also. So right now, no value is there. I can give null, N-U-L-L. Null means no value. It can be given like this. So null in the sense, right now, no value. So if we want to fix that, the column is there, but I can't able to see the null values. Value should be there. In those case, I can apply not null constraint there. And next is unique. Unique in the sense, if you feel the certain column should be unique. For example, mobile number, account number, all those things should be unique. If it is assigned for one employee, it should not be given for the, if the mobile number is given for one person, it cannot be repeated. Same way, account number given for one particular customer, it should not be repeated for the other customer, which could cause the confusion. So these things are not possible. And next is primary key. Primary key, I'll let you know what is this primary key by using example. And next is foreign key. these two are important one, right? Apart from those, we are having multiple constraint like check constraint. Okay, it is used for checking and ensuring the column values, whether it satisfies the condition or not. And default value, we can set the default value. As you see in the programming, we can set the default value. These are the different types of constraint. We'll see by example one by one. Okay, first we'll go over with the, we'll start with this primary key and foreign key. And during the implementation of these one, I'll let you know other implementation also, guys. One by one, we'll include along with it. Here, whenever I say primary key, the column of a table should be unique and should be not null. Primary key column should be unique and not null. So you can notice that the column like mobile number, student ID, employee ID, it can be given as a primary key. So let me create a small table for the example of primary key. Here, I'm going to create a table. So let us assume we're going to create table customer. We create a table called customer. Okay, and let us assume this customer has certain information. Let us assume this customer has customer ID, which is of integer type. So we are seeing this not null constraint, right? So whenever some customer is buying some product, he will be given the ID. So without ID, there will be no customer, right? So I can assign not null as this column. The same way, I can accept the first name from the customer. First name, I can mention where care of. I can give like Varkera 50. I can accept last name. Where I can mention Varkera 75, some name. And if you want, you can accept age with an integer. That's it. So now I'll show you people how to create a primary key. This is a normal key column, right? If you want to create a table, you'll be mentioning like this. If you want to, what happens here? Now, if you want to assign, you know that this particular column is a unique column, isn't it? You want to make it as a primary key. In those cases, the primary key can be declared in two conditions, guys. One is during your declaration. One's the creation of a table itself, I can create a primary key. Okay, the other constraint is the table has created without primary key. Now we want to make the particular column as a primary key, then that's possible. Two conditions is done. So right now, if you want to create a table along with the primary key, I can mention primary key, and whatever the column you want to make it as a primary key, you'll be making here as a primary key. Primary key. And followed by the column which you want to make it. This will be made as a primary key. So once you fix the column as a primary key, the column will accept only unique and not null values. So no null values will be accepted in case of this primary key column, and it will accept only one unique values. Okay, I'll let you know what is that unique values in this. Something is there. We'll see what is that. Okay. No. Is it throwing some error? Syntax is error, it seems. What is that? Just a minute now. I don't see it. Comma is not there. We left the comma here. That's the reason. These are separate columns, right? So follow by comma, follow by the primary key. That's it. So if you do this, the table will be created, customer table. Now, if you want to insert value table, let us show you the two insert operation. Okay, insert into table name. Insert into table name is customer, isn't it? Customer followed by values, and the values be right now 300. Let it be a ID or 303. 303. Let it be a ID. And Robert John, that will be the name. And age be 20. Okay, I guess all the information is given. So this is that. So let me execute this. You can notice that this is working fine. So if I'm going to create one more value, what's the name I can give? Sarpriya, some name. So, but I forgot to modify this custom, this ID. So now let me try to do it. You can notice that it will throw you the error that duplicate entry for a primary key. Duplicate entry for a primary key is not allowed. It will never allow it for your insertion operation. If you forgot also, it will never allow it. This is the advantage in case of setting a primary key. Once it is set, it will never allow for the other value to be as a primary key. This is all about making a primary key during a creation of a table. In case you forgot during your creation, if you want to alter the existing table, in those cases, you can do one process. So next is, let me tell you people how to alter the existing table after the table is created. Okay, after the table is created, if you want to do it, then I can mention alter. You want to alter the table constant, right? So they'll be mentioning alter table name. For example, let us take our customer table. Let me mention here as a general. Alter table name. Now what you're going to do is you're going to add a constraint to the particular table. So I'll be mentioning add followed by primary key. Got it? Add primary key and followed by the column which you're going to mention a primary key you're supposed to mention here. This is supposed to alter the existing table which is created already. So if you want to create during your processes, you can do it directly. So if you feel that the table has been created and later on you want to add it, then you can do this one. Got it? You can do for the existing table, but make sure that the column in a table should be unique. So if it is not there, it is not possible to do it and throw you an error. Okay. So this is all about a primary key. And this primary key can be added along with one additional property that is nothing but giving name for it. Giving constraint name. I can give a constraint name. So why is this constraint name required? So when I'm creating a huge data, so when I feel there's some conflict is there, I want to remove this constraint, this particular primary key constraint. In those cases, I can generally mention the particular constraint name alone to remove the primary key. Meanwhile, during your process, if you feel that the condition whatever you apply for a column has to be given with some leverages. I don't want the condition strictly to be followed. In those cases, I want to remove the already assigned column. Then I can mention constraint name. It will be easy for us to remove it. So the same table, if you want to alter along with some name, then I can mention alter. Okay, table name. Okay, here we are going to mention add. We are going to add a constraint for this. Constraint is a keyword, guys. We are going to add constraint. Here I'm going to give a constraint name. This constraint name can be a user defined name. I can give any name for this constraint, but make sure that this constraint name should be unique. And what is the constraint name you're giving for? You're giving this constraint name for your primary key. So this primary key is a keyword. So for your identification, I'm giving guys, if at all you want a lowercase also, you can do it. And followed by the column you want to make it as. Those column can be given here. guys, if I mention column, it doesn't mean a single column only is supposed to mention as primary key. I can mention as many column I wanted. So if you are going to mention more than one column as the primary key, then the key will become as a composite key. Got it? If more than one person in a table is assigned as the primary key, then the particular column is called a composite key. When only one column is assigned as the primary key, it is called primary key. If you are going to assign the key constraint for more than one column, then it will become as a composite key, guys. So this is all about your primary key. After creation of a table, you can add it, you can alter the table constraint like this. So maximum everyone will have a habit of giving along with the constraint name. Okay, now I'll give you a few more information, guys. Now the primary key has been created. Now I don't want it. In those cases, what I can do is I can drop my primary key. When it is not required, I can drop my primary key like this. Dropping primary key. Guys, these are the important key syntax, guys. The syntax is required for you, okay? Alter, table, and followed by my table name. Okay? And here, directly I can mention drop primary key. So if I mention drop primary key, then what happened? The particular whatever the primary key is there, it will be dropped. Okay? This is how to deal with your primary key. So far, I given an example how to deal with your primary key. Is it clear? Can we move for foreign key? Shall we move for foreign key? Come on. Okay, good. Now, let me tell you what is foreign key. Difference between primary constraint. What is it, Samir? What is this one between constraint? I couldn't get you. What is your question all about? Under constraint, we'll be seeing primary key. Which may be people confuse. Constraint in the sense, under constraint only, we'll be having these things. So we are having not null constraint, unique constraint, primary key constraint, foreign key constraint, check constraint, default constraint. Okay, these are the constraints, conditions where I can apply for creating a table. Constraint name you are asking. Here, I'm just giving this primary key without a name. Primary key constraint without a name. Here, I'm giving with the name. That's the difference. This name will be used if I want to release the primary key or if I want to do some operation with the key constraint, I'll be using it. I'll let you know with the example, okay? For the joins, we'll be seeing with the example. Okay, we'll be mentioning constraint. Whenever you don't want it, just you can remove this constraint for this particular table directly. Okay. Fine. Now we'll go back. We are discussing about this. Next topic we came to discuss about the primary key and foreign key. So look at here. There is one table and this is the other table. Let us assume right now we have created customer table, right? And this is your customer table. And let us assume this is your order table. This will have customer ID, customer information, mobile number, phone number, all those things. Okay. This will have this information. And this will have order ID. This customer has given. And we'll have the customer ID. We'll have customer ID. And we'll have order ID, isn't it? We'll have order ID, customer ID inside your customer table. So we are having two tables. One is customer table. This customer table has your customer ID. Okay. And this particular table has your further information. Also, customer name, customer information is there. And this is your order table. An order table will have a customer ID, which customer has ordered the product. And what is the ID of the product? And what is the name? And what is the quantity of the product he has ordered? You'll have this information. So you can notice that there is some relationship between these two customers, right? So if you want to make some relationship here, so here what I told you, this customer ID is a unique. So what we'll be doing, we'll be making this particular column as a primary key, isn't it? We'll be making this as a primary key. The same customer ID which is occurring in the other table, here this particular column acts as a foreign key. Got it? The primary key of one table acts as a foreign key of other table. So what is the use of it is the main advantage of it is I can make some sort of relation between the two tables. In the next forthcoming sessions, we'll be seeing about the inner join, joining two tables and finding the result. So why should we join two tables? You can notice that in a database where all the information cannot be stored in a single table. So it will be breaking down into multiple tables and it will be storing the data. So if you want certain information, I'm supposed to combine more than one table, then I'm supposed to fetch the information based on my requirement. Here, the same way, when I want to combine more than one column, then I should know, I should have some constraint. I should have some common column between both the tables. In order to establish the relation, we'll be having primary key and foreign key. And we know that the rule for a primary key is unique and not null. Okay, the same constraint is applied for a foreign key. It should be unique and one null value is allowed. And primary key of one table is a foreign key of other table. So with reference to the customer table only, order table is going to be there. So here the customer ID is a foreign key and this particular customer ID is a primary key. And according to this order table, I can assign this order ID as the primary key. Order ID for each and every customer will be unique. Clear with the primary key and foreign key? These are the most important questions there. What is primary key and what is foreign key? Is this clear? Where to use primary key and where to use foreign key? Shall we go ahead with the implementation? Come on. Respond me. Clear with the primary key. Okay, you want to repeat it one. Oh, okay. Just now I erased this one. Okay, better I'll put a proper table for you people. Assume that this is a customer table. Okay. Assume that this is a customer table. Okay. And assume that this is your order table. Okay, here this customer table could have multiple columns. This customer table could have customer ID and he might have customer name. And he will have address, mobile number and all those things. Okay, these columns will be in a customer table. If I say order table, this particular order table will be having information. What is my order ID? Okay, and which customer has ordered it? I'll have customer ID and followed by the product. What is the product you have ordered it? And what is the quantity of the product you have ordered it? Quantity, which is nothing but number of product you have bought it. So you can have these information in this particular order table, isn't it? So here you can notice that here this particular customer ID is unique. And here I can make this customer ID as a primary key. So I can make it as a primary key. So this follows the condition unique and not null. Same way here you can notice that this particular order ID. So this order ID is unique. So this order ID is the primary key of this table. So if I want to relate two tables and I want to fetch the information like if I want to fetch the customer ID is there. If I want to fetch the customer information, which customers ordered this product? If I want to fetch it, is it possible to fetch by using order table? It is not possible. If I want the customer info, then I'm supposed to refer my customer table. So there should be some common columns between the two, both the table if you want to relate it. So the common column is a customer ID. So if you want to make some relationship, I'll make this particular column as a prime foreign key. So this is the definition. Primary key of one table is a foreign key of other table. So which will have the same constraint what the foreign key has, but this is not a primary key. So by using this key constraint only, you're going to relate the two table. Is it clear now? So this is unique and not null. And this is also unique and not null. But what happened? Here this information is I'm going to relate with the customer table. So I'm going to make it as a foreign key. Is it clear? Shall we go with the implementation of this foreign key? Okay, good. Let me go back here. And we have created this customer table, right? So let me create order table also with a foreign key. For creating a foreign key, this could be a syntax. It will be like create table followed by a table name. Let us consider table name is order. This is your table name. So as we say, let us assume this particular table has these information like order ID, which is of integer type, and followed by your customer. It's mentioned generally as ID alone. Okay, so you'll be having ID. We'll have ID here. ID is of integer type. Okay, the same ID. You can notice that here I used ID, right? The same ID I'm going to manipulate here, and followed by product. Product, let it be Varchar of 25. So if required, you can add product ID also. PID, just a minute. Product name, it will be product. There will be product name and it will be product ID. PID, which is of integer. Now we are going to see how to create a foreign key for it. What happens here? I don't see it. Yes. Create table name, right? Okay, we'll see to it what happened. Everything is nested properly. Yes, order may be order by. Okay, then we'll consider orders. In case of order, we'll consider the orders. Now look at here. I'm going to make a column as a foreign key. So if you want to make a column as a foreign key, I told you that one column should be made as a primary key. So for making a primary key, what I told you can mention primary key. And which is the column you're going to make it as a primary key, you can mention here as what is the column? It's order ID, right? You can mention order ID here. This is your primary key. And next is foreign key you're supposed to make it. And foreign key you'll be mentioning as foreign, comma should be there, guys. I missed a comma. Let me put comma here. Foreign key, and here what you're supposed to do is you're supposed to mention which column you're going to make it as foreign key. Here I'm going to mention this ID as my foreign key. So let me mention this ID. So in which reference to which column you're supposed to make a prime foreign key. So in reference to the call table customer which has a ID already, I'm going to make this as a foreign key. So I can mention reference with the table called customer. Okay. Reference with the table called customer, and there is a column called ID. So based on this column only, we are going to make this as a primary key, a foreign key. Just a minute. Or you give me references. Is it clear? So this is a statement, foreign key, primary key, we are seeing it. For foreign key, foreign key of ID, which column you're going to make it as a primary foreign key. This ID is the one which is we are going to make it as a foreign key. If you are going to mention some column as a foreign key, you're supposed to mention in reference to which table, what is the column name. So in reference to the customer table, there is a column called ID. So based on this, I'm going to make it. Got it. Here you can notice the ID is lowercase and the ID is given in uppercase. So this is done. So now once I create it, now you can notice that this table will be created. What happened here? Foreign key ID. Just a minute, syntax error, what it is. ID only, right? Foreign key of ID, right? It is not required to be a same name. Statement is right, but it is saying that database student does not exist. Why it is all of a sudden? Just a minute, guys. It is saying there is no database at all. Just a minute. This is there. Just a minute. This order is not creating. Just now order is created. Okay, order has been created. Now, whatever you're going to insert it, it is based on your primary key column, guys. If you want to insert some data, it depends upon your primary key column. Okay, now let me show you some examples. Insert into our table name is order. Okay, our table name is order. Let the order's ID be 400. This is the order ID. And let the person ID, here you're going to use ID, right? This ID is reference to which one? The existing customer table. So existing customer table has 304. I'll mention this ID 304. And let the person name be Ganesh. Okay. And here, next is, let the product ID be 001. That's the first product, okay. Product name is there, right? Okay. Product name, right? Sorry, guys. I thought it is a person name. Sorry. Product name, let it be pen. Pen or paper. Okay. And followed by the product ID be 001. So first is your order ID 400. And next is the ID. ID depends upon your customer table. And followed by the product ID is pin and product ID, product name is pin and product ID is 001. So what happens here is there is any column missing. Insert into table name. Sorry guys, I missed out the syntax. Listen here. Now this is done. So you can notice that now I'll show you the what is the problem will be there if you're trying to insert other values. That is the reason I'm trying to show you people. Listen. So if I feel that select star from orders, you can notice that the order table is there right now. These are the values inserted. So let me insert the one more value here. Okay, one more value here where the product ID is different. But if I give the column, listen carefully, if I give the customer ID as 300, okay. If he is ordering the same product, when I try to execute this one, look at here. What happened? It is showing one error. What is that? Cannot add or update child now. The foreign key constraint failed. The reason is here we know that whenever I say customer table has a only element 304, that is one customer, and 303 is customer. Without the element in the customer ID, I can't able to insert here. Clear with the point? What I'm saying, there is no customer ID call 300. So if I try to insert the column here, if this will be affected. It will check with here whether is there is a customer ID call 300. If the person is not there, it will never allow to insert in your order table. So then if you want the customer, if you insert the customer ID 300 there, then it will allow it. Clear with this one, how this foreign key and this primary key relation works. If you want the reverse order, then make it this as a primary key and a foreign key there. Okay, that is not so. This order table is dependent on your prime customer table. Customer table is not dependent on the order table. Then if you want it, make it so, then make here as your foreign key. You can suppose that foreign key here based on your order table. Then it can able to reverse is possible. Got it? Okay. So if you insert this particular customer with the ID 300, so if I insert here with the 300, okay, now if I insert this one, this is done. Now when I try to execute this, you can notice that this is working paka. So previously what happened, this particular customer ID is not there, so it is not allowing. Now once the customer has had it, now we can insert it. This is the main relationship between the primary key and the foreign key. This is how you can do it. Okay, and apart from this, I guess you people are clear. Maybe people clear with this primary key and foreign key. What happened today? Strength is very low. It is only 64 people. Sunday morning effect, huh? Is it so? I didn't notice the count so far. Just now I noticed it. Every Sunday is fun day for you people, huh? Okay. Yeah, good morning. Okay, listen. So in case of foreign key, here also I can able to create along with the constraint name. This foreign key can be created constraint name. So if you want to create along with the constraint name, just you're going to mention add constraint. So I'll tell you people how to create along with the table name itself. If you're going to mention create table, okay, they will ask the question from the syntax only. So be clear with the syntax alone. Table name. And here you will have all the columns. So what are the columns? We add it. We will have all the columns like this. Okay. Just I don't want to type all the columns here. You can have all the columns here. And followed by, if you want to add some constraint name, then followed by the primary key, you're supposed to mention like this. Okay. We'll mention constraint followed by a constraint name. Constraint name, constraint followed by the constraint name, this is good, and followed by foreign key, and followed by the column, which is a column, you're going to make it as foreign key, the column name, and here, in references with which column, the same condition, guys, previously we have mentioned this, till this you have mentioned, right, if you want to give constraint name, you're supposed to mention in references constraint. Is supposed to mention constraint name. The same syntax what we made previously for the program, just you are supposed to mention constraint name is required. Okay, and references with the particular table name, the primary key table. Let me write down in references with your primary key table, your PK table. Okay, table name and followed by a primary key. Primary key name should be main. Primary key column should be mentioned here. So this all will be creating along with the constraint name. Okay. Now, if you feel the table has been created, now I want to alter the table. In those cases, you can mention alter table, your table name. Okay, for a table or existing table also, it can be added. You can mention add constraint, constraint name. Okay, constraint followed by a constraint name. Then we can have foreign key and followed by the column name in references list. The same thing, guys. The syntax is almost same for everyone. The small variation with alter table, table name, followed by add constraint, constraint name, foreign key, followed by the foreign key name in reference with your primary key name, followed by the column. This is how to do for your foreign key. This is to create it and this is to alter it. If you want to drop it, I don't want the particular foreign key. If you want to drop it, then I can mention alter table, followed by your table name. I want to drop my foreign key. In those cases, I can mention drop, just mention foreign key. And here you can mention this foreign key alone can be dropped. Directly, I can't able to drop it. In those cases, I can just mention my foreign key name. This constraint name you are given here, right? You can mention this constraint name here. Here, foreign key constraint name can be mentioned here. So what happened, that whatever the constraint you apply will be dropped for the table. This is all about the constraint which you're going to apply, foreign key constraint and primary key constraint, guys. Okay. And if you feel that you want to apply the check constraint, we do have check constraint also. Check constraint you use for checking the values. For example, you can take this table. There's this table. You can take this table. Here we are given the age, right? If you want to add some constraint here where age should be only between 18, I should not give the age which is greater than 18, should not be accepted. In those cases, I can add one more constraint which is available, that is all about the check constraint. Normally in certain website, the people who is below 18 is not able to use it, right? All those things make use of check constraints here. For check constraint, so during a table creation, you can use this one. We'll alter this table. Right now, I'll show you along with the table creation, and later on I'll show you how to alter the existing table now. So along with the table creation, you'll mention create table and follow by our table name. Okay. And you'll mention as many columns you want that you can mention here. You mention as many columns. And here, for example, for age, I'm going to apply check constraint. So I can mention age, which is data type is integer. And here I'm going to apply check constraint whose age is greater than or equal to 18. Then do insertion operation. If the input value which is less than is given, it is not allowed. This apply the check constraint during your creation of a table. If you feel that I want to alter the table condition, I can do alter the table after creation by adding the check constraint like this, alter table, okay, followed by your table name, add your check constraint, add the check constraint whose age is greater than or equals to 18. You can add the constraint like this. You can add multiple condition. You can have unconditional also, whose age is greater than 18 and city should be only Chennai. Like this, I can add multiple conditions like this. I'll show you the example here, guys. Right now we are dealing with age, right? We can add some constraint for this table. Right now I didn't give any constraint. So now let us give some constraint for this table. So you're going to alter this customer table and I'm going to have customer only the person who is above 18. So what I can do is I can mention alter table followed by the customer. I'm going to alter this table customer, and here I'm going to add my check constraint here. Add the check constraint where there's a column called age. and this column called age should accept input only greater than or equal to, we can have about 20. Okay, 20 and above. We can have this constraint. So once you mention like this, what happens? So make sure that once you're altering the table, the already existing table should, existing value should not have any conflict. So already existing value is 20, 20, 20 and 23. So if I give some value called 19 and if I'm trying to alter the table, it will throw you some sort of error. The reason is already the existing table, you're altering it. Some values are there. You should satisfy this condition. So for the newly created table, empty table, there is no issue. Okay. When the existing table you are trying to do it, you will have certain issue. You're supposed to be cautious about it. So what happened? So this, but you can notice at the bottom, three records has been affected. These three conditions has been checked with the constraint. It is following the constraint. Now it is okay. Now let us try to insert a value based on this constraint. So let me give a customer ID as, okay, I can have, okay, this is that. Now let me give some age which is not violating. Let us give 18 or 19, something which is less than or equal to 20. We are given the constraint, right? If I try to insert this record, you can notice here, check constraint, customer checks one rule violator. The rule has been violated. It is not 18. For 18, it is throwing an error. So for 19, it is throwing an error. So below 20, whatever the input is, it will throw you error. And those cases, you are supposed to modify the condition. Okay, with any value, and your subletters have a unique value here. So now if you execute it, it will execute it. So these are the importance of constraint. So if you use constraint, I can able to apply some rule for constraint in the sense rule. The whatever the column which is created, you should follow the rule. If the rule is not, it is violating the rule, it will never allow us to create it. You can notice that some form also where the particular form, if you are not filling something, it will never allow you to submit it. Okay, those type of forms will follow this rule. And next is, as I spoke to you about this default value, right? If the particular column is not there, then set the default value. Here I can able to set default value also. Okay. So normally you can, during your creation of a table, here I can mention this particular column. If you want to make this particular column as a default value, you can mention default. Okay. You can mention default and you can set a value for this default. If the order ID is not given, default ID is not one. I can set like this. If you want to alter it, then I can alter the default ID. So let us assume alter table and followed by the table name customer. Okay, here if the name is not given, I want to make it as a default name. So then what I can do is I can mention default, not for name. Okay, let us keep for name is the only column which is left over, right? So you can mention for name. You can mention create alter table name. You're supposed to mention add constraint followed by the constraint name. So let us mention this constraint name as for first name, right? Let me mention f underscore name. This is the constraint name, and here I'm going to mention a default. I'm going to mention default, and the default value is I can mention some XX value. If the value is not given, I can make an XX for followed by my first name. For this column, I'm trying to apply it. Just give me a second. Let me see what it is showing. Contract. It is not applying. Alter table name. SQL Server will use it. Okay, the syntax will be very little. Alter table name follow by, okay, just a moment, guys. Alter table name, alter f name, okay, alter f name, set default. Default value as xx. So if a input is not given for the particular column, then the default value will be made as xxx. So you can have a condition like this. Let me have some name here. I'll show you what happens. Okay. We'll complete with this statement, guys. Okay. You can mention insert into table name followed by, let us mention the column name here. Your column name is important if you're going to avoid some columns. So here your first column name is ID. So we'll have the first column name here and followed by, here right now I'm not going to give first name. So in those case, let me go directly to last name. Where is it? I'm going to give last name and followed by age. So only these information I'm going to give it. Okay. So first name, user has missed it. He didn't give it. So now let me execute this. It is executing fine, right? Now let me try to show you what will happen by default. Select star from customer. Okay, if I execute this, you can notice that where this particular person, where what happened? It should be replaced with null, the xx values. It is not conflicting. Guys, let me check with it why it is not showing xx, okay? But actually this value, instead of null, it is showing null, right? Instead of null, it will be having xx values. It will be replacing with xxx. So the default value should be replaced. Let me check with it and let you know by asking, okay?